Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Alessia and today we'll talk about the implementation and applications of topological sort. Let's take this graph. What will you use if you wanted an ordered list of nodes such that if the red arrow is an edge, F would appear before B in the list? A topological sort, of course. Let's go deeper. After applying the algorithm to the graph, we will obtain a topologically ordered list, Q, or vector, depending on the implementation. However, it is important to remember this simple rule. There is no topological sort if a graph has cycles or is not directed. Now, let's take a look to the data structures we'll use during the development of the algorithm. Obviously, we'll have a graph. As you can see, each graph node has a value, a list of outgoing edges, and a counter of incoming edges. Besides that, we'll need two queues. One, called the process next, will progressively store the next nodes to process, while the other, called order, will store the topologically sorted nodes. We will begin the implementation by writing the code for the graph and for the graph node. This will speed up the testing phase. Let's now start the implementation of our beloved topological sort. First, we create the empty queues we need. Then, with a for loop, we count the incoming edges for each node. Now, let's identify all the nodes with no incoming edges and add those nodes to process next. After this, we can write a while loop to start processing the nodes. We dequeue the first node from process next, and we go through all the nodes that belong to the node's outgoing edges. For each of those, we decrement the counter of incoming edges. This happens because the dequeued node is about to be added to the topological sort, so it's basically irrelevant. After that, we check if the counter is now equal to 0, and in that case, we add it to process next. When all the nodes have been added to the topological sort, we check if order contains all graph's nodes. If it does, we return order. If it doesn't, we return none. Now that we completed the implementation, we will test our algorithm on two graphs. For the first, we'll create the graph from the previous example, which has no cycle in it. Alright, this last line will check if our algorithm generates the right ordering of the nodes. For the second test, we will build a simple graph with a cycle, and then we will check if it returns none. Okay, our test class is complete. Let's run it. Good! No errors. Since all tests went well, let's now analyze the complexity of the algorithm through big O notation. From now on, for simplicity, I will talk about vertices and edges instead of graph nodes and outgoing edges. Let's see. Besides the space needed to store the graph, we will use an auxiliary space O of V, with V representing the number of vertices, and this is the space needed for the two queues. The time complexity is a bit trickier to obtain. The presence of two nested loops in the two pieces of code that determine the algorithm's complexity could make you think that the complexity derives from the multiplication of the number of vertices and the number of edges, but that's not correct. The key concept here is that the number of edges is distributed across each vertex of the outer loop, and this leads to a complexity of V plus E. By now, you probably know that topological sort can be used to detect cycles, like we did in test number 2. However, it's important to know that it also provides a valid ordering for an assembly line. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. I want you to know that the complete code is available on GitHub, and if you enjoyed the video and want to support me, like the video and subscribe. Ciao!